In my previous lecture, that is the scattering theory part 1, we have seen the way to calculate the differential scattering cross section using a continuity equation. And in my previous class on Green function, that is introduction to Green function, I have informed that the importance of Green function will be known when we are dealing with the scattering problem. Today we are going to see about the Born approximation, which is a very very important problem in quantum scattering. Here I have used little mathematics. With little mathematics, I have tried to explain the Born approximation. With that introduction, we will move on to the scattering theory using Green function. Scattering theory, sorry, the use of Green function in scattering theory. Before going into the detail of Green function, we will see the one of the main application of Green function in well-known problem of Poisson equation. We know very well that from Poisson equation, del squared pi is equal to minus rho over epsilon naught. And in my lecture about the introduction to Green function, I have explained that Green function should be constructed in such a way that when the differential operator operate on the Green function, it will give a delta function. The delta function is nothing but a shift function. For example, here delta r minus r prime. R prime is the source, and r is the distance of the particle or wave under consideration from the source point r prime. So once you know the, if you construct the Green function, it is easy to solve problem because it is after all a shift of source from r prime to r. The idea behind this one is to construct the Green function. Delta function we have seen in our earlier class about the introduction to delta function. So even though the delta function is improper function, we can construct the delta function using a Gaussian function with a particular condition that Gaussian width is zero and a Lorentzian function and in Fourier transform like a triangular pulse. So we can construct the, we can make use of the proper function as a delta function that I have explained in my class about the Dirac delta function. That is the interesting properties of a delta function. Once if you are able to construct Green function means you are, then you can easily solve your problem. Here we will see the why I have taken Poisson equation is a well-known problem. From the definition, we can write the solution for the Poisson equation is pi of r prime is equal to, that is, we can construct, by definition, we can construct using Green function, this pi of r prime is equal to integral g r r prime rho prime over epsilon naught tq r prime. If you operate on this pi with del squared, here del squared will come, Green function will give you the delta function, and naturally the outcome of this right hand side is, because it is it will become, when you introduce a del squared in the left hand side, you have to use you have to introduce a del squared in the right hand side also, that is a del squared, that differential operator operate on greed function will gives you the delta function. So naturally this rho that is nothing but delta r minus r prime t cube r prime. So this is only a shift function. This rho of r prime will be shifted to rho of r, and the overall integration, that is integral of delta with respect to r, will be equal to 1. So you will obtain the exactly the Poisson equation. So this is the well known result. But from the electromagnetic theory, we know the pi of r prime is equal to integral of rho prime t cube r prime over 4 by epsilon naught r prime that is modulus of r minus r prime. So this is the from electrodynamics point of view. Now if you compare these two equations, here there is rho over epsilon naught, here also rho over epsilon naught and integral. So you can easily identify just by looking into these two equations, you can easily identify the green function g r minus r prime is equal to 1 over 4 pi modulus r minus r prime. This negative sign is normally a conventional one, because here also you are getting negative sign. Normally negative sign is used as a sign convention, that is the negative gradient of potential is equal to force, we know. So it's after all a sign convention, so we need not confuse about it. So this is the green function for in the electromagnetic theory. This is also, if naturally if you differentiate this, if differential operator act on this, you will get the delta function. That is the idea behind it. So once if you could construct a green function, means you can easily solve the problem. This is as far as electrodynamics is concerned. We will see what will happen in quantum theory. Green function and Born approximation. Let us take the Schrödinger wave equation as usual. Psi of r is equal to minus h cross square over 2m and del square psi plus v of r psi. So this is the potential term, or perturbed term we can call it. Now you just multiply this equation by 2m over h cross square. So you will get 2m over h cross square. This h cross square 2m will get cancelled. Here you will get 2m over h cross square. Now you keep this 2m e over h cross square as k square. So you can take this as k square. Dimensional by dimensionality also it must be a k square. So then you bring this del squared left hand side, so this will become del squared plus k squared multiplied by psi, and which is equal to 2m over h cross squared v psi. So this is the final expression after just rearrangement. It looks like Helmholtz equation. Now for homogeneity, you assume the right hand side is zero, that is no perturbation term. Then it will become del squared plus k naught squared. K naught is the initial wave vector into psi naught r is equal to zero. It is a homogeneous equation. The solution for this homogeneous equation is psi incident wave, that is incident wave is equal to psi naught r, which is equal to e power I k naught r. And the general solution can be expressed in terms of green function. Say this solution is only for if it is homogeneous. Here we have a perturbed term. So this equation is an inhomogeneous one. So you have to take care of this also. Hence, the general solution can be expressed in terms of Green function, treating this 2m over h cross squared v of r as u of r. So the blue color rectangular box is taken as terms in the blue color rectangular box is taken as u r prime. So now the generalized equation is psi as a function of r is equal to psi naught r plus integral the Green function multiplied by u as a function of r prime psi as a function of r prime t3 r prime. Now we will see about the Born series. We have seen already that total wave function can be written as psi naught integral g. Here I have replaced g by g plus. So normally it is written as a subscript, plus is written as subscript. As I am following the notation used by SIF because of the uniformity, I have introduced g plus here. Instead of g, I have made it g plus as a function of r and r prime, u r prime, psi r prime, t3 r prime. So this we have seen, except only thing is I have made this as plus. There is a reason for it, you know very well. Plus indicate the retarded Green function, that is the propagator. That is only at the point r prime I am introducing the perturbed potential. So that is the meaning of this propagator. If g minus means it is advanced Green function, that is backward propagation, this is the forward propagation. Forward propagation is called retarded Green function or propagator, which I have mentioned in my introductory class on Green function. So the g plus or minus as a function of r minus r prime can be written as e plus or minus ik modulus r minus r prime over 4 pi r minus r prime. In the case of electromagnetic theory, this is 1 over 4 by r minus r prime modulus this term. Here we are dealing with the wave function in quantum mechanics, so this is the plane wave equation. So in the case of quantum theory, this Green function can be written as this form. In electrostatic, numerator 1 is a changed by the plane wave equation. So that is the only difference. This you can easily prove, but that is not my aim. So you can take it as granted this one. Only if g plus means this one will be plus, if g minus means it this will be minus. Now you assume the wave is traveling along the z direction, and this is the perturbed region, that is the where potential has influence. I have shown in red color circle, arbitrary circle. This is very small. Assume it is very small. According to Born approximation measure, it should be very small, and the scattered wave is along this direction. We will see what is Born approximation at the end of this lecture. So now you substitute this g plus here, so naturally this will be minus. You can take out, this will become e power I am replacing g, that is Green function, by e power I a k modulus of r minus r prime over 4 pi r minus r prime, and u r, this remaining term will come as it is. Now you assume, because according to Born approximation, this potential is the disturbed potential is very small comparing the incident wave function. So this r prime is very smaller one. So r minus r prime is taken to be r, simply r. So you can change the denominator as r, no problem. But in the case of numerator, there is one more factor is there, that k. So you cannot approximate this as r minus r prime as r here, because that approximation depends upon k value also, whether k is larger or k is smaller one. If it is comparable, then this is we have to keep in mind this is an exponential term, so it will change drastically. So you are not supposed to change the numerator, because we don't have idea about k, whether it is small or larger one. So you keep as it is, only you change the denominator as r, because r prime is very very small comparing r. That is also the one approximation we will see at the end. So this wave function can be written as here the numerator become r. In the exponential I have taken the first term, that is e power ikr here, ikr over r. I have taken this r, denominator r, and the first term of the exponential term, that is e power ikr over r. I have taken this out of integration, because the integral is over r prime, not over r, so we can safely take it out. Then I have kept the remaining term as it is. Only thing is I have taken the first term, the second term will be e power this minus ik r prime. Ik r prime is here. So it is interesting to compare this with our previous case. We have seen in the case of elastic collision, that is in my previous lecture, how to calculate the differential scattering cross section, we have used this wave function. This wave function here, it is normalized, of course, e power the wave function, total wave function is equal to the incident wave function and the scattered wave function, which is equal to e power ikr plus f. This is a scattering amplitude, which is a function of t and phi only. It does not depend upon r, that we have seen in my previous lecture itself, then the rest of the term. So in the previous class I have shown that t sigma over t omega is equal to the square of the modulus of the amplitude of scattering amplitude, that is f theta psi whole square. This is so if you know this parameter, that is which I have shown in the blue color rectangular box, this is the scattering coefficient, that is f theta phi, then we can calculate t sigma over t omega. So naturally, by integrating it over t omega, you can get the scattering cross section, and that is our main idea. For that, we have to construct the green function for bond series. That is the important of green function in scattering problem. Now we will see about the bond series. Finally, we have arrived with this expression. The zero to order solution for this is that is for zero to order, that is no perturbed potential, this will be zero. So you have left with only the first term, that is pi naught r, which is equal to e power I k naught r, where k naught is the wave vector of the incident wave. pi naught is the initial wave function without any perturbed potential. That is zero to other solution. In order to find the solution of first order, here we are following the iterative method. The first order solution psi 1 is obtained by plugging the psi naught into the above integral. You plug the psi 1 in the integral equation, then you will get the first order solution. That is psi 1 of r is equal to psi naught of r. We are dealing at the position r1, so everywhere r prime is changed to r1 here, and here r1, here r1. So I have introduced zeroth order solution. That is not introduced, I have inserted the zeroth order solution. That is psi naught at r1. Similarly, the second order solution can be obtained by plugging into this equation, that is psi 1. After calculating psi 1, you plug the psi 1 into this equation at the position r2, then you will get psi 2 r, the wave function is equal to psi naught r minus this thing. Here everywhere I have replaced r prime by r2. In that way, you can go for third order, fourth order, like fifth order. You can go up to nth order. Now we will see the first order Born approximation and its validity. The scattering potential V at r0 is localized, that is, at r0 is equal to 0. This potential exists, and potential drops to zero outside the finite region that I have shown in the earlier diagram. If the potential UR is weak enough, it will distort only slightly the incident wave. So the scattered wave approximately considered as the incident plane wave. In first part of approximation, the scattered wave function psi of r is approximated by a plane wave. This approximation corresponds to first iteration in the Born series. I have shown the first Born series and second Born series just now. And the first Born approximation is valid whenever the wave function psi of r is only slightly different from incident plane wave. So, under this condition only, this Born approximation is valid. This is about the Born approximation. Here I have made a very simple derivation. I have used only little bit mathematics. Thank you very much for your support by watching my videos. Thank you.